for the second half of this evening is Katrina Davy. Katrina, when asked what she wanted to be when she grew up, said she wanted to be happy. Tonight she will share with us a story about how she found peace and happiness in the most unexpected way. Katrina is a poet, storyteller, and she is on the most creative adventure of her life. And her story is called Me and Anne. Please welcome Katrina Davy.
This there is for my friend Anne. She's very shy and nervous. Her last name is Diety. I'd like you to meet my anxiety. Anne has been with me my entire life. At 5, she really started to take control. She was very smart, and she said she'd look after me, so I believed her. But she was scared of so many things. I don't want to go to that new school. Please don't make me. That tree, there's no way I'm climbing that one. It's too high. At school, I had to do a lot of things that Anne didn't want to do. Like at my flute recital. Here I go, I'm ready to play my flute. Anne reaches up, grabs my hands, and starts shaking them. It was so embarrassing. As I got older, Anne found new ways to communicate with me, and I found it really hard to ignore her. I'm 8 now, and I'm so excited I get to dance with the boy of my dreams. Anne reaches, grabs my hands, puts them in a bucket of sweat, and he says, yuck. I'm 16 now. I'm absolutely exhausted. Anne talks to me during the day and all night long. I can't sleep. I'm at university now, and I have to go to a hospital for work experience. I hate hospitals. Anne's terrified. So she creates a new shortcut. She pushes the faint button. And I do. I'm at my research methods exam. I've studied so hard for this exam because I'm really terrified of it. It makes no sense. Anne decides she's got a new shortcut. She pushes delete. And I cannot solve a single equation. Despite Anne's many protests, I decide to take her on adventures like ab sailing, rock climbing, roller coaster rides on top of buildings in Las Vegas, and also traveling overseas. I had a marvelous time. Anne totally freaked out. She cranked up the volume, and she gave me chronic fatigue and pain as her new voice to communicate with me. I had to learn to listen to Anne. At 38, a true miracle happened for both of us. We got married to the man of my dreams, not the one from when I was 8. He was amazing. He loved me, and he loved Anne and all her quirks. At our wedding day, Anne had a chair. It was right behind me, just in case she pushed the faint button during my vows. We also had our vows written down on a card, just in case she pushed the delete button. But Anne did not do any of these things that day, because for the very first time she felt loved, appreciated, and cared for. So today I'm here to really thank her and pay tribute to her by a poem that I've written. Me and my anxiety, a beautiful couple, she and me, been together all my life, made it through tons of strife, never leaving my side, faithful and dependable, but she's lied about what's possible for me to dream, kept me safe with her inner scream. You might think her a bad friend, wonder why I didn't put an end to our life together, but you see, I tried. Therapy couches, but she just hides. Hop right back up when I was through. Best therapist didn't know what to do. So I decided to sit down with her, find out what her demands were. But you see, I was totally wrong. Anxiety just wanted to come along. So we sat down and talked about who was right and how maybe her boundaries were a bit too tight. She told me she'd quieten down if I'd just listen and not drown out her protesting cries to stay home, ignore her and leave her all alone. I agreed to listen more, not just close her out, shut the door, promised I'd be there to ease her pain, to guide and love her, soothe the pain, and ease the strain. So this is why she has a chair. On this stage, she feels your stare, but she knows together we are strong, our friendship and bonds many years long.
Storyteller.